end is to please God before man. Amen?
Amen.
So we as a children of God, we see three things that happen in this place. The husband or the man feared God, but he didn't leave anything for them. Okay? It can happen even today. Okay? There's two men of God who just worship God. Okay? Who are not interested in the earthly things. Amen?
Amen.
The second thing that happened, she knows where she has to run to. She runs to the right source. And when she gets the help that she needed, she obeyed. There's an obedience there. You know? The only way we can get anything from God, if we trust and obey God. There's no any other way. Okay? Even though we come here every Friday, or we come on Sundays, but still, if we do not trust God, we cannot receive anything from God. We also see in the book of Genesis 8, chapter 12, when Pastor read last time, that really touched me. He said, as long as the earth remains, there will be seed time and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night will never cease.
Mm.
You know, when I look into it deep, I just realize what that means. It's a kingdom principle.
Oh, yes.
Okay? We are in the month of prosperity. If we do not sow seed, we don't receive. If you like pray from 19, 20 years time, it's a principle. You don't pay your tithes, the devil comes. Amen?
Amen.
So we should mature in these things, okay? If you do not sow seed, don't give your offering, because your salvation and your measurement, how you love God, don't just come from talking from your mouth. It must also come from your attitude towards God. And God said, you give, you receive. To the point whereby, say, press them together, rolling over. So we should come to the point whereby we say in this life, what are we actually doing? We should just step back and just look into what we are doing. I was discussing with our sister today when we were coming. I said to her, for the fact that I came to realize how God operates, how God wants us to live. Sin is not an issue. Can we just understand that? Sin is not an issue. It's ignorant of us not knowing the laws and the things God wants us to do. Once we came to understand that and believe in our heart and do not walk by sight, okay? It doesn't matter how long it takes. Amen?
Amen.
If it takes for ages, it doesn't matter. What matters is this. Do our faith in God remain firm? Are we praying? Are we having a relationship with God? One-to-one relationship. What do you do when you wake up in the morning? What do you do before you go to bed? What do you do at your workplace? How did people perceive you? Who are you in Christ Jesus? Once you came to understand that you are firm in the Lord, everything that happened on the side, you don't look right, you don't look right, you just stay firm. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Jesus.
Amen.
So I come to a conclusion in this. I say, there's no any problem or any need which we have in this life God cannot meet. So if everything is possible for God, then what can a man do to us? Why should we be afraid? Okay? When there was some time the bills comes, I don't look at them. The reason why I don't look at them is this, because the more I look at them, I'll start thinking, I don't want to have anxiety or this depression. I just overlook it. I just hand it over. I just kneel down and say, Father, this is your problem. Deal with it. Amen? Because the Bible asks us to cast all our cares to God, because God cares for us. Amen? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise God.